great migration to the north, the revolution of 1896, Bataan and Corridor. All these have led us inexorably to this watershed. This is the high moment of our history, the great star of our warriors. Their one vision
and one dream.
Freedom. We have come at last to the true fulfillment of this dream. For the greatest act of freedom is the writing of the Constitution against this ultimate act of freedom. All other acts of history, seen and heard, are at best a leisurely movement.
Write our Constitution is for the past, the present, and the future to come. Together, all at once, in one single motion, in one single view,
one single fight,
for we correct the errors of the past and chart a new course for the future. Based on experience of the present, as our progress have sought to establish the first Asian Republic, today, we test the principle that a democracy is the recuperating,
self-healing,
and a just, and a social, and economic order may develop to corrupt a democratic community. But so long as the people believe directly
or indirectly,
these can be rectified. Society can be revolutionized by institutional means, not by destroying,
but strengthening democratic institutions.
This we do, beginning today.
And I would come with your behest to express in person the fervent hope that I share with all the people that the Constitutional Convention succeed in its noble task to meet the great expectation of our people in Philippine Constitution. For whereas the earlier Constitution was drafted in a most lively shape by the Council and in many respects at the initiative of an alien power and approved by that alien power, the Constitution you are now asked to write must be, and I hope, will be a Philippine Constitution.
The representatives of the people in Congress and the Presidency initiated the call for a Constitutional Convention articulating the will of the sovereign people. The dreams it must fulfill are the dreams of an independent Filipino nation, and are undisputed by the ambitions or interests of another nation. The Constitution you will write is envisioned by our people as an embodiment of Filipino aspirations to a Filipino progress built upon Filipino energies, opportunities, and resources.
Our delegates will be today to begin rebuilding the foundation, the pillars of the national life. We find ourselves summoned to an equal task. This is the task of providing the moral climate of cooperation and support, without which this great opportunity for human growth in this part of the world must surely pass unfulfilled. I have come to offer that cooperation.
For the price of a successful new charter is unity. Neither the meaning of a new constitution, nor its blueprint of ideal principles, is assurance by itself that we shall attain peaceful, abundant, and meaningful life, which alone is the object of our endeavor. Freedom itself is an act of faith.
The delegates go to their historic mission with the confidence of the people and their ability and willingness to describe narrow interests, so that neither political ends
nor personal fortune
nor fanaticism shall stand in the way of a charter expressive of the true aspirations of our people. We shall hope and pray that the peaceable spirit shall descend upon the deliberations of the delegates, so that harmony shall illumine the course of your proceedings, so that conflicting viewpoints shall yield common comprehension, and hostility or ill will shall not undermine the work of the convention.
The new tribalism engendered by organized anarchy must now be discarded in favor of national unity. We shall not ensure calm and orderliness that can guarantee success of our effort.
The Constitution, old or revised, cannot alone solve all the intricate problems of our nations. It holds no easy or magic cure.
But as the testament of human vision, it provides a rational basis for confronting those problems. Everyone in the nation knows, with the knowledge of the heart, that we are embarking a national animal that deserves nothing less than a wholehearted respect and attention of all.
For you write the Constitution which shall be the fountain head of wisdom.
In the days above, when our nation shall be confronted with new dangers, our Constitution
Constitution shall be there to guide us in our work.
In the long tortuous struggle of a small and aspiring nation, our people shall be tempted into erratic and advanced action.
The Constitution shall be there to lead us into severity and nations.
The Constitution should be the bedrock of our republic.
And today, we start to write that Constitution.